So, what we considered that we have now, we considered the main mechanisms of a multi-agency. They were communication, cooperation, and negotiation. The next two lectures, I mean this lecture and next one, will be more about technological aspects of multi-agency. How to build systems that employ characteristics and mechanisms that we considered previous. So it will be more technology oriented. So, but today we start with multi-agent system architectures. And here we consider, first of all, low-level architecture. Because we are interested to see what are main mechanisms, how agents could efficiently implement their features and characteristics. And from this low-level mechanism and architecture, we briefly considered black boards and actor architecture. They are related to communication architecture. Then we considered higher-level multi-agent system architecture based on middle agent, and an example of this will be a system called RISC. And then we consider another approach to build infrastructure that use so-called wrappers. And example of this architecture will be Archon. And after that, we consider two market-based architecture. So they are implement a marketplace idea as a basic element of architecture. There will be two systems, Magnet and Agora. Why I put a question mark here? Because Agora is our system. We develop it. And I don't want to promote my things in this course. So I will not go into very depth about that. It will be not part of your exam. But it's good for you to know about what's going on around you. So let's start. How we consider what is the multi-agent architecture? From other, one side, it's quite easy. There are tens, maybe hundreds of systems that are multi-agent system tools. And we can just look into them and see what are their architecture. But we are interested in more general mechanism, what is more globally common for such system. And from this point of view, this context of multi-agent system extend notion of intelligent agent, first of all, because it introduces possibility that agent can be created by another agent. And this means that it can delegate tasks not only to human, but also to other systems, to other agents. And agent must be designed with explicit mechanism for communication and direct and interacting with other agents. These are two aspects that we should take into account when we consider multi-agent system. What is multi-agent system architecture? Basically, there is even the definition. It's not widely accepted definition, but we can consider it as a working definition. Infrastructure for multi-agent system is a set of services, conventions, and knowledge that support complex social interactions. So it's a set of services. We consider multi-agent system architecture and infrastructure as a set of services that support communication, negotiation, and coordination. So this is what is our main approach. And what kind of services? Very many, just to mention some of them. For example, enable to find each other, so naming service. Services to support communication, or security constraints, satisfaction, and so on and so on. Basically, there are many possibilities to have with these services. And this is one of example what kind of services a multi-agent system may have. It's proposed by Kathy Sikar, one of quite well-known researchers from Carnegie Mellon University in USA. And this is nice architecture, but it is not like a standard architecture. It's not that everybody uses it, everybody agrees. It's mostly considered that we can use it as a reference architecture in order to understand what kind of structure it should be. But it's not necessary that all multi-agent systems should have this And in particular, it was proposed that this architecture is like multi-layer architecture. It includes individual agent infrastructure and multi-agent system infrastructure. And the bottom level of this is operating system, and all this stuff that we use from standard software. Then on top of that, we should have communication infrastructure for multi-agent system and communication model for agent. This is just to enable communication, discovery, component message transfer, so very basic component. Then on top of it, we have ACL infrastructure, agent communication language infrastructure, if you remember, that is used for ontology or protocol server, and in particular agent, it will be a parser and private ontology and private entity. When we have this, then on top of this, we can build already management services like logging and visualization services. On top of this, we can build performance services, for example, monitoring, reputation services, and so on. On top of this, we can build the security mechanisms, and then name to location mapping, agent naming service, ANS component. So how to map agent name to particular location. And next level, when we have such infrastructure, that is quite communication oriented, we can consider also capability element. For example, middle agent components. We will consider what is middle agent could be, but basically you can consider, for example, that facilitator is a middle agent. So, and on top of this, you can have interoperation infrastructure or a component, and interoperation allow you to have communication between different multi-agent system implemented in different environments. So it can like a translation one service to another service that implemented in different languages and different environments and so on and so on. So what we have? We have, first of all, very tight connection to operating system and all this low-level environment. At the same time, on top level, we see that we have a kind of interface or translation service that allow one multi-agent system be mapped to another multi-agent system interface. And in the middle, we have important middle agent and other services that are related to communication. Again, this is not necessarily that all multi-agent systems have all these components, but some functionality somehow is presented in every multi-agent system. Okay, so this is a basic view of what is multi-agent system architecture. It's a set of services, and these services include different services for naming, for communication, for parsing messages. Important distinction also is middle agent component that allow you to have some facilitator or matchmaker. And interoperation element that allow you to communicate with other system. But this element is not actually very much developed, because usually each environment, each multi-agent environment, is self-contained. It doesn't assume communicate with other multi-agent environment. But if you would like to have different multi-agent environment, you have to think about this component. So this is basically the general view, but we start bottom up, and we start to consider what are basic element or what are basic approach to build communication infrastructure, starting from low level architecture. And from this point of view, there are only two ways of communication. You remember I mentioned it previously, it is shared memory and message sending. In shared memory, we consider how we can communicate via some common pool where everybody writes something and everybody can read something. There is no direct communication. And message sending or message passing is when one agent sends message exactly to some other agent or some set of agents. Okay? So from this perspective, we have two types of architecture. And this is basic approaches, but they can be implemented in different way and on different levels. And from multi-agent perspective level, we consider what kind of first common memory or shared memory approach can be implemented, and second, what kind of message-based approach can be implemented. And as an example of generic architecture for multi-agent system shared memory approach, we consider blackboard architecture. Did you hear about this in previous courses? You didn't have courses on AI. No? Okay, then it's better. I will start from scratch. So, what is metaphor? Metaphor is the collection of intelligent agent gather information, gather around some blackboard or whiteboard, some place where everybody can read and write, and look at pieces of information and think about them and some conclusion. It means that we have black or whiteboard, we have agent, and agent only communicate with blackboard or whiteboard. Okay? So I write something, another can read it. And that's all. And this is what is kind of communication. Some basic assumptions are that all agents can see all of the blackboard all the time. So all information on blackboard is available to all agents. So you don't see only this piece. You see everything. Any agent can write his conclusion on blackboard at any time without getting into in anyone else's way. So write is atomic. So, and asynchronous, no law. Okay, and the last one is act of agent writing on blackboard will not confuse any other agent and their work. So if I do something and write, I don't interfere with other agents. Okay. Idea of this blackboard architecture came from AI and in more particularly from natural language processing environment, and it was implemented for translation of natural language. Key idea that for blackboard architecture is that problem solving should be incremental. It means that everybody I write some agent not just write whatever they want, they try to solve problem. Or this solution is like incremental. I write something, another in the response write something else, and so on, so on, and finally we get our problem solved. And opportunistic, it means that system choose action, the next action, the best action that can be make the best progress towards meeting our goal in the current situation. So because problem is that it's not enough to have this blackboard. We have to organize something, how to use it. Because everybody write, everybody read, but still there be some order. Okay, I write something and somebody else writes something, we can trigger something, but what to choose, this or this? We cannot choose everything at the one in one time. And so we need to make a decision what to do next based on information that we have on blackboard. But we should choose the most informative and the most useful for us element of written information. Okay. So, if we consider the blackboard architecture already as a figure, then we can see that it is very simple. We have blackboard. They are called knowledge sources, but actually it's synonymous to intelligent agent, because when the blackboard architecture was proposed initially, there were no such a notion as the intelligent agent, and then it was like transformed. Okay, and what are main components? Blackboard, it is global database containing data and hypothesis and partial solution. And it can have some structure. For example, we have different parts of blackboard associated with different level of knowledge. For example, in natural language translation, there were some parts of Blackboard that were related to translation of words, some other parts related to translation of sentences, and so on, and some part of the whole story. So it depending, everybody can write and everybody read, but you allow that you have different types of information in the structured information of this lecture. Then we can have agents, and we have control mechanism. And control mechanism is very important because it will say what happened after somebody writes something into Blackboard. So basic thing is that agents do not communicate directly. They communicate to Blackboard. And then Blackboard should motivate others to do something. If I write something, who will be triggered by this event that I wrote? You and you or you? It depends. So there should be some control mechanism who decide how to operate, how to do, to select the next source of information. Okay, and then the main control problem is that we need to have such a control mechanism that allow us to select the best action to execute next. And Blackboard must have such a control mechanism that effective allow us to do selection of next action, taking into account both goal-directed factors, what is our final goal towards we go, and data-directed factors, what is the best to do according to information that we have already on the blackboard. So there will be some direction where to move and some direction what we can do. So both of these factors should be quite important. Blackboard control is difficult because, as in our we already considered in coordination, that it is difficult to predict what happened after your decision made. So you need to you need to take into account that your action will trigger some other action, and this other action will trigger other action, but what are these actions you have to take into account? And before we start to consider particular examples of Blackboard architecture and mechanism, we consider one important element of this Blackboard architecture that is called serialization hypothesis. In principle, idea is that all agents can write and read whatever time they want. But this is not efficient. Because there should be some kind of order in which they can do this. And this order is ensured by some serialization that agent are schedulable entity and only one can write at any time. Control mechanism select only most productive knowledge source at any given moment to work on the problem. Another hypothesis, another idea related to serialization hypothesis is that Blackboard is not globally visible. Can you imagine that you have to implement system that has a huge Blackboard, hundreds, thousands of agents writing, and everybody can see everything? So there can be some kind of localization, as I told you already, for different levels, but important that if you need some information from this local view that you see, you can obtain this information by a special request. So potentially you have access to all information on Blackboard, but from efficiency point of view and implementation point of view, you look only into some place or some location in Blackboard. You can see one place, another in one place, and so on. Okay, there are many assumptions, and is also another assumption is that knowledge sources operate within a valid or consistent context. It means that if you have some object features presented on Blackboard, they are the same in all parts of Blackboard. Okay, now in order to understand this, what I told in more general abstract way, we consider the particular example. And this is example of first type of blackboard architecture that is called agenda-based control. What we have here, these are agents, but not resources. This is a blackboard. Each agent can write into blackboard. And act of writing generates some event. Event is processed by some blackboard monitor. It's a component that monitor what's going on in the blackboard and what should be reaction. So everything that something happens, somebody write, is monitored by blackboard. Then when it something appear new, then the monitor select what are other agent whom this information may be useful. Okay. So you write whatever, but it's only some of agents who can use this information. And this information that can be used, it will be sent to particular agent as a pre-condition for their execution. So blackboard monitor like a select agent who can be triggered and then send them information, you can be triggered. Okay. Those of them who said that yes, we can, we want to do this, will be then put into agenda list for execution, and their input will be instantly. So the work is like agent write, this generate event, there is a monitor who according to event and some information that it knows about agent, will select those who will be triggered by this information. Those who can be triggered then will reply if they would like to be triggered, can be triggered with this information in some reasonable way, and they will be put into agenda. And in order to execute, there will be some other component called scheduler who will select next element from this agenda list. Okay? Is it clear? I think it is quite obvious way. But what is also interesting, that in order to have some control over what we will do, there is a rating of agents that can be triggered, put into agenda with some rating. And there is a block that will monitor this rating. And basically it is called focus of control database. It means that it will rate some agent execution higher than other agent execution or triggering because of some information. For example, it can be assumption that some places in our blackboard are more hot. So we use them, if we use some information, then we most probably we will use it in some sequential way. So we will use it more. So those who are related to this particular area where something happened, where events are coming and going, so then this area will have more priority. So agents who are bound to this area will be more prioritized. Okay. So this is basically how it can be. But of course, you are free to implement whatever control over rating and agenda as you like. Next slide, just repeat what I said, because it's not good text in textbook about this part. I try to give you some text that you can read afterwards. Also. So this is just repetition what I said in short. But there are some modification. There are some modification of this type of control, where we can have not one, but many event lists that are triggered by blackboard. It means that everybody writes into blackboard, but event can be generated, that are generated afterwards, that are classified according to different property. For example, blackboard event list are the same as previous, but we can separate that there are some special clock events, so there are some agents that wait for some time to appear in order to be triggered. Then, expectationally, there are some agents who are waiting for some particular type of information. So this is why we know when agent communicate, they also can present what they expect, and they expect some event happening. Then this is can be called the expectation event list. And then it can be a problem event list where agent report where events are placed that related to problems with solving our task. And then, in addition to our monitor, there will be some strategy module who decide which event to choose first. So it's just a more sophisticated way of previous agenda-based control that we consider. That in agenda-based control, we consider that all events are the same. Now we consider that events can be different, and we know that there are different queue of events, and we put them into different queue, and then which other event which to select depends on our strategy mode. And then there will be some particular monitors that consider blackboard event management, clock event management, expectation event management, and process. So this is like foundation for communication. We consider that agent communicate via blackboard mechanism. How we can implement this efficiently, blackboard mechanism. One way to consider so-called agenda-based control or event-based control. Next type of blackboard is more sophisticated and more interesting. It is called goal-directed control. In this case, we have not one, but two blackboards. Okay. Agents still write in only into one of the blackboards. It also generates some events, but instead of monitor, we have Go processor. And this Go processor has different mapping. First of all, it can map information that on the blackboard to particular agent and put this into agenda. But in addition, it may map this into some goal to be achieved. So there is no direct information that I put on the blackboard that other agent directly say. It's mostly like I put some goal to achieve. And in order to achieve this goal, some action should be taken. So it means that it's first is quite direct communication as previously, but second, you can put, okay, this information, I don't know which next agent it will trigger. But it will generate some other element that we call goal, and we put into blackboard, goal blackboard, that after that can be from this goal can be sub-goal generated, sub-goal, sub-goal, sub-goals, and finally we find some agent who will act according to what we need. In some sense, you remember our goal tree for coordination. So it means that actually agent will perform this action that are pointed here. But information that is put is here. In order to find who will perform some action, you need to apply some rules that are inside of the goal processor that will consider, okay, from this goal I have two sub-goals, and from this sub-goal I have three sub-goals, and finally this view particular agent to perform some action. So in addition to just direct triggering of actions, you can have some control mechanism that allow you to make reasoning, to make some more elaborated purchasing of your goal. Is it clear? Okay. So basically, it is the same that we have something written and somebody has to read this. Problem is only to decide who will read and what. In first case, it is directly that I write something in previous architecture. I write something, and when I write, it's directly identified who will read it. And my point only to choose that there are many possibilities who will read different sources, and I choose only one. Now, this architecture allow you to do more. It says that, okay, writing into blackboard actually doesn't immediately initiate or trigger some action, but it may be used to produce some more events. This is done here. And from this event that came from our agent, we can generate different events, and finally we find that some of them can be put into this agenda list. And then schedule can be used. Okay. It's simple architecture, but I would like that you understand main approaches that can be used. We consider the shared memory approach. With this shared memory approach, we communicate indirectly. And then there is a problem. How to choose who will be triggered, whom this information will be useful. This is a control problem. If what is much better with message-based communication is that I send exactly to agent who is will use it. Now I don't send it to agent, but I send it to some place where many possibilities exist. And we only consider what is the main approach to solve this problem of control. First, you put this monitor, and by monitor you decide who will next, and then you have scheduler. By rating, you say how to choose. And one example of how to rate, for example, if some areas in our big blackboard is often people, agent write only in this area. It seems to be this quite hot, and maybe only we consider agents who work in this area. Blackboard are highly rated. Okay? And second approach that we consider here, goal directed, then we don't have direct triggering, but we have possibility to include whatever mechanism we would like, for example, goal sub goal reason. Okay? Okay. Next two slides just explain what I said. Not a yes, please.
You go back on.
Yes, please.
I don't really get what's the point of go blackboard.
Yes. Oh, go blackboard, okay. I write some source, some there, but there is nothing that can be triggered. Mm-hmm. For example, bring or close the door. And there is a, no, I don't know whom to send. So I put this as a go. And then I can see, okay, in order to close the door, there can be some actions. It can be divided into first find agents who are in the neighborhood, then check their, for example, this will be my first sub-goal.
But that is done by the goal processor, right?
Yes.
Then why not, once you know what you need to do the sub-goals, then you go to agenda, then back to the agent.
Yes. After that.
Why do you need the goal blackboard?
Sorry?
Why do you need the goal blackboard?
Here, because this event, okay, I understand what you mean. Point here is that to make this mechanism as general as possible. So you can implement this goal processor as a monitor reacting to events. Because it can take this event, and it can take this event. And this will be the same. Okay, this is point. Actually, yes, you're right. But point is that it put it, but it doesn't mean that immediately it start to make this reasoning. It's only make work by events. And the first event will be, okay, there is another goal. Second event will be, okay, I produce these two sub-goals and they come as event to me. I check, okay, there is nothing. I put them again. Okay? So it's like, it's not one step reasoning, but it is step by step, and each of them is one event. Very good question. If you have questions, please ask, but then they allow to clarify. Okay? Is it okay? Okay, the next two slides, just repetition of what I said. This is why I skipped them. But if you remind you something, if you don't have recording, what was this about? Okay? What else we can do with blackboards? Actually, how more features into blackboard we can add? We can consider that actually blackboard is not one blackboard, but distributed blackboard. Because keeping one blackboard for everybody is a create a bottleneck problem. But we can consider that there are many blackboards, that but they have some structure and connection. This approach was proposed by the Koch and Scherer Wang and Beck, and they suggested an architecture that is quite simple, even trivial architecture. But we can have a hierarchy of blackboard, and if some goal come to this blackboard, but there is no any sources that can be find important to understand what should be triggered, it will be forwarded to upper level blackboard. This upper level blackboard will see information necessary here, and if not, then it will send to upper blackboard and so on. So quite standard line architecture. And finally, it can find the source or data that is necessary. After it is found, it may happen that it will inform agents who will be triggered by this event, communicate not with this blackboard, but with this blackboard. But basically, it is only a different way of implementation your one blackboard architecture, one blackboard database. Okay? So instead of having one pool, we have hierarchy of pools, and in order to propagate some data from one place to another, we have such approach. Okay, and in order to finish with blackboard architecture, let us consider one particular example of how it may work with agents. Let's consider example of some system where we have the following types of agent. User interface agent, agent who communicate with user on native natural language. Database agent who can communicate with database and find information. Calendar agent, one agent that could consider what is your calendar and in order to find, for example, person where a particular person is in some particular time. Is there a meeting, is there a lecture, or whatever. Mail agent who monitor mails, news agent, and telephone agent who will call you if necessary. Let's consider the following example, how they can be organized using blackboard approach. First of all, we have a blackboard. And then we have all these agents that I named. There is no maybe news agent because it is not relevant to our agent. But basically interface, calendar, database, phone agent, and mail. So I would like that when mail arrives to me about security, get it to me. This is my goal. I put it into blackboard. Okay? This is what I want. We also consider that if this goal is put on the blackboard, it will add trigger to mail agent. Okay? Mail agent, when this email arrives, it will also put on the blackboard goal, where is user? Because in order to notify, I know, I have to know where you are in order to send you a message, maybe call by phone. Automatic machine. Okay, then it will trigger calendar agent who will find, okay, it is in room 17, in south there, as we now are. It will be put on the blackboard. Then a male agent who is now operating as a monitor will, okay, then consider in order to call this agent, we need to find what is a room number or telephone number for this room. It will be put this event to blackboard. That will trigger database agent. And this database agent give us telephone number, short number, because we are inside of the same building. And then mail agent will put this trigger to phone agent to make call to this agent, to this person. So this is pure way how it works. In this case, we know exactly that particular event or particular message that put onto blackboard will trigger particular agent. We know how to find. What is also interesting to see, there is no explicit monitor. In this case, male agent plays also a role of monitor. You can consider that monitor implemented inside of some agent. You don't have to need, do not need to have separate monitors. Okay? Okay, and then it will work. Questions? If no questions, that is time for break.